But let me remind you that today and yesterday we celebrated the feast of the Holy Translators, of the Holy Armenian Translators, which reminds us something very important, that Armenian was one of the first languages into which the Bible was translated. The Bible, my dear brothers and sisters, is one of the most widely published and widely translated written works in all of the human history. The Old Testament was written originally in Hebrew, as well as in parts in Aramaic and Greek. After Hebrew, Aramaic and Greek, one would expect Latin to be the next major language on this list. But there is other very early translation record. Armenian officially adopted Christianity early in the 4th century in 301. All Armenian chronicles maintain that the lack of the Holy Scripture in the local language was an obstacle to missionary work. Therefore, the main motivation behind the creation of the Armenian alphabet, itself by Nestor Pashtots, lay in having an Armenian Bible, which was referred to us as the Holy Book, Sirkir, but more often it's called Asrazashunj, inspired by God. There is evidence of Syriac and Greek influence in the Armenian translation of the Bible completed by 436. Scholars often mark this translation as the queen of the versions for its style and liturgical rendition of the original. In fact, the very first words written in Armenian by Armenian letters come from the book of Proverbs, Proverbs of the Old Testament. Janachel zimastutyun, yeloserat imanal aspatis hanjarov, to know wisdom and instruction, to preserve the words of understanding. I can say today, my dear friends, that though these words have become the cause for the celebration of the Feast of the Holy Translators, that the Armenian Church used to commemorate their holy works and to usher the golden age of the Armenian culture. This celebration also is an occasion for us to rededicate ourselves to learn and appreciate the Armenian language and our cultural heritage as a precious treasure which has been carefully passed from generation to generation. The concert Life is Better with Music is dedicated to the cultural month of the Armenian culture. You don't need today to know more about Morris, but I can say that Deacon Morris wants to be an Armenian priest and he hopes to attend St. Nurses this fall 2019, and he also plans to use his voice every single day to send the message of God. And Morris grew up here in our community, in our church, and you know him very well, and therefore he will give his message. Give Sursur by Makar Ekpanyan, Nur Zarek by Nesne Shnurari, and You Raise Me Up by Rob Loveland and Brendan Graham. Let me introduce you Deacon Morris Lahan. Who are the Holy Translators? The calendar of the Armenian Church mentions the following Holy Fathers: Saint Sahakin Mesrop, Yerishe, Moses the Poet, David the Indictable, Gregory of Narev, and Nerseshnorayim, says the Grateful. In fact, my dear friends, the word Tarkmanchas, translator, has two meanings. In the narrow sense of the word, there is the translation of the Holy Bible into Armenian and many other important classical books and written during the 5th century, which is called the Golden Age of the Armenian literature. However, the other writers who are commemorated during the Feast of the Holy Translators have contributed numerous hymns, prayers, pastoral letters, philosophical thoughts and analyses which helped to establish the core of our patriastic writings and theology. Let me introduce you the other performer today, Professor David De La Mora. He is a professional classical musician, orchestra conductor, and violinist, and he holds a position of music faculty of Georgian Court University in Lakewood, New Jersey, director of the music ministry for the University High Campus Ministry in Newark, New Jersey, and also he is the voice and music teacher of our Congress. He will play violin for us, Cello Suite number 1 in G major for viola by Johann Sebastian Bach, and the second movement of this suite, Gig, by Joseph Sebastian Bach. And he is going to play viola for us.
Thank you.
perform for us. Opera Mille Fou, opening aria from L'Opera Sarse by George Frederick Handel. Broken Bow by Laura Fabienne and Walter Afanasiev. If I Can Love Her from the musical Beauty and the Beast. Maurice Lahav.
Oh, Thank you. Face to face,
Thank you. So today we can say boldly that from the beginning the Bible has been at the center of Armenian spiritual, philosophical, intellectual and artistic life. During times when national identity and survival have been threatened, the Bible has been a source of strength and comfort. Today we are going to conclude our concert with a beautiful song, Yerevan Yerevani. I would like to invite you to join us in singing Yerevan Yerevani. And again, thank you, Maurice and Professor David, for being here and to perform for us and to remind us that the culture is more mostly important part of our life. The music is better when the life is better. Yerevan Yerevani. behalf of our community, I would like to thank Maurice, Deacon Maurice Lahan, and Professor David for this wonderful concert. And in the conclusion of our concert, you know, we are Christians, we should say a prayer, and we will go home very, very, very happy, and think about the music, and think about our life, because our life can be better with the music. The music which is created by the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Spirit, depart in peace, and my Lord Jesus Christ be with you.